this is great, and I'm thinking about Christmas presents for my kids and kits and all that stuff. So my question, you know, we saw in the DIY fair, the Bonavet guys have the Arduino boards, and they've got the little bits and all that. So it's coming, and I think more people are going to get exposed to it. But how prepared were the participants to kind of get muck in with that stuff and touch things and pull things apart and figure out how it worked and make all that work? Because I sometimes feel in the things that we do here that people aren't as comfortable, or they think it's only for the geeks to mess around with that stuff. So how comfortable were they with it?
Okie dokie. So how able, in a way, are people to get in touch with the potential in these devices? I'm just trying to pull up a photo again, actually, because I think it kind of speaks for itself. We had a really fun guy called Alex. So it depends a lot on people, right? Depends on how you present this stuff. This is a really fun guy called Alex who came from the Smart Citizen Project. I like this photo, right? Even in the UK at the moment, you know, there's a massive gender discrimination in terms of technology. These girls aren't supposed to be interested in technology. They definitely aren't supposed to understand it. But that's why I think something like critical pedagogy is a useful way of getting people involved in it. Because it's not about the technology. The goal here is not, yeah, I understand some technology. The goal here is what's happening with the air that I breathe, right? And this thing can help me, so I'm going to understand it. So that's one possibility, right? I think with all this technology stuff, it's not focusing on the technology and saying, hey, that's really cool. I'm somebody who understands Arduino. I don't give a shit, okay? What are you going to use it for? Right? What kind of approach? So it's also about the social. It's not just about the technical.
Any more questions? If not, then I would like to have a round of applause for Dan one more time for the presentation. So up next, we have a panel, which is about the metadata and surveillance, a really interesting topics these days around the globe, a topic that has not been debated much in Kosovo here and also in the region. For that, I have a really distinguished expert, starting with my colleague Vladan, Stefan Urbach, we have Flutra Gusari, and Arini Dobroshi is about to come.